Having issues with selling your books? Well, you've come to the right channel because I've talked about how to get more book sales. But one of the things I haven't talked enough about is what's stopping you from getting more book sales. So today I'm going to talk about five reasons you're not selling more books. Stay tuned. Hey, what's up? It's Dale here, and we're just going to jump right into things. I'm going to talk about the five reasons you're not selling more books. Let's just cut right into in the order of importance. I'm actually going to discuss some of the issues I see a lot of independent authors doing that's holding them back. Reason number five is no clear audience. Okay, it's awesome that you have taken a lot of time, energy, and effort and probably put a lot of expenses into your book, but if you don't know who you're writing for, then chances are very likely a lot of the audience that you're writing for aren't going to be able to find you. So if you don't write for someone specific, then you're writing for nobody at all. And in turn, what's going to end up happening is you're just going to get buried in the mess that is Amazon or any other platform for that matter when it comes to publishing your content. Reason number four, poor keyword choice. Keywords play an integral factor in your discoverability. And if you aren't utilizing the right keywords, then your audience won't be able to find you. It's much like a conversation. In that, you know, at a cocktail party, everybody's gathered together, they're having some conversations, and someone's talking about, let's say, doilies. And yeah, I got about a four or five people that are coming around. Now, some people are probably gonna come into the conversation and thinking, okay, doilies, that's something I like, and they'll kind of gather there. But if somebody's walking by, they hear him talking about doilies, they're like, that doesn't interest me whatsoever, and they just wander off. I want you to think of your book in that same way and like a cocktail party, in that you need to be saying the right words to welcome in more people to your little inner circle, known as, of course, your book in this analogy. Don't take this lightly when it comes to selecting the right keyword choices. You need to select not just a keyword that's profitable, but a keyword that has perceived relevance, meaning that it makes sense attached to your book. I see far too often a lot of indie authors go and they find some profitable keyword, they put it on their book, and they're going, why am I not selling any more books? I put a profitable keyword on there. Well, it might not make sense. So if you've got a book that's a unicorn coloring book for 3 to 6 year olds, and you decide you're going to go ahead and put a keyword on it that's unicorn books for 12 to 15 year olds, well, then there's a little bit of a disconnect. Even though that might be a profitable keyword, someone's going to go over, they're going to discover it and go, oh, that's not what I want. And they'll deuce out, and here it's going to drop the relevance of your title online. Reason number three, a bad book description. Okay, I get it. You took all the time out of your day to really craft an amazing book blurb. But the problem is, I see a lot of authors out there that do a lot of just telling what's inside the book instead of showing, or for that matter, compelling the browsing customer to purchasing their book. So instead of spending so much time talking about this character and just talking about that character and what they're going to be doing here and there, you got to create some type of intrigue. You need to lead with a good hook. You got to give good substance and great ad copy that gets people reading from top to bottom, and finish it out with a good call to action. That way people are buying your book. A bad book description will stop a lot of people from purchasing your book. Reason number two, a bad book cover. Everyone judges a book by its cover. We're meaning this in the literal sense. And if you have a bad book cover or something that is not representative of your niche, then chances are very likely they're gonna pass. I see far too often a lot of indie authors have an amazing looking cover that's fantastic, but then when you go to compare it to other books within its niche, as well as the best sellers for that niche, you see there's a disconnect. And though you might think it's a nice cover, the browsing audience probably doesn't see it in the same way. And the way I see it is this: if you're right now struggling to have some type of sales with your book, I want you to look at that book cover and be very real with yourself. And if you're doing it yourself, you may want to consider hiring out. However, if you're doing it yourself and you don't mind having any sales, then you shouldn't be complaining, or for that matter, you're probably not even interested in the rest of the video, because I have one more reason. It's a very big reason why you're not selling more books. But first, I want to talk about today's sponsor, and that is going to be Lulu.com. Are you interested in independent publishing, and have you heard of Lulu? No, it's not Lululemon. We're talking about Lulu Press, who does print-on-demand books. In fact, they've been in the game for a long time, since the early 2000s, providing high-quality printing at a low cost, and more ways than ever to connect with your audience. Best of all, everything on Lulu is completely free to use. Yeah, free, my favorite word. And look, there's no upfront costs, there's no hidden fees. It's just great print-on-demand to help you get the most out of your book. Just visit the sponsored link at dalelinks.com/Lulu to set up your free account and today and try it out for yourself. And by the way, I'm going to give you a little coupon here. The coupon code is going to be DALE20 if you want to get 20% off your print order. Reason number one, you're not selling more books. This is the biggest culprit there is. No promotion. You can't just simply publish your book and pray for the best, because honestly, your prayers aren't going to be answered in that capacity. You need to take the time to let people know that you've published your book. Let them know who you are as an author. Let them know that you have content out there. And the thing is, this is in perpetuity. You have to continue to market and promote time and again and again and again. And just when you thought you're done promoting, you're gonna continue to promote some more, because if you wanna see more book sales, you have to market and promote that puppy. Hey, if you found some of this information very useful, hey, this is Self-Publishing with Dale, where I'll show you how to publish books that sell. And if you would like that too, make sure, of course, you hit the subscribe, ring the bell notification on so you don't miss a single one of these videos. And speaking of marketing and promoting, I actually got this very next video right over here where I talk about marketing and promoting your book. I'll see you on over there.